Cool. So I am here with Richard Cook. Kind of the reason why I'm even at PAX is Richard is the director of the documentary Pixel Poetry, which I am honored to be in. And it's a fantastic movie. If you haven't checked it out, go to GOG.com or pixelpoetry.com. Richard, tell me why, like, how did you come up with this concept for the movie?
So it started with the whole games as art debate. It really started about with things like kind of getting out of hand, I guess. And then, you know, you had the famous Ebert quote and all that stuff. And then it just died down a little bit. But I think we still like suffer in a progression in a weird way to get gaming into the limelight, I guess, the mainstream media and the greater public and all that stuff like that. So I wanted to be a cornerstone for that. And so I made Pixel Poetry to emphasize where we've come, you know, as a creative culture, where we've come from and how we've progressed and all the things that have helped with that.
What I find is really fascinating is when you interviewed me, kind of the original concept was, you know, are games art, was the question.
Yeah.
Can games be perceived as art?
Right.
And then, but it really kind of evolved from that. So if you watch the documentary, it's much more than that, and it's almost like, how are video games perceived by people in and out of the industry, right?
Correct, yeah. It started out as the games as art thing, and then I got on a Destructoid article, and I started getting in a discussion with people on that, and they were like, oh, this is a tired debate, blah, 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 stuff like that. So I was like, maybe I should do something more with this. So I started thinking about the games as violence thing. I started thinking about comparisons to things like movies and stuff, and music as well, and it just bloomed from there. And I just created it out of, you know, my love for how far we've come as a media, because it's nice to see, you know, good things on the news. And like on, you know, main news channels and stuff like that, people are talking about great things in games now and all the good things they're doing. It's not so much bad stuff anymore. And I think it's really, you know, it really fascinates me how far we've come with that.
So what I find is really funny is that you actually got positive feedback from an internet forum and it led to like making a better movie, which is generally not the case because people can be terrible on the internet.
Yeah, it's generally not the case. I mean, we just had our Twitch stream last Friday as well. And I think over at one point we had over 1,000 viewers watching it. And I kind of went into it nervously, like, okay, there's going to be a lot of trolls there, you know, I don't really know what to expect, stuff like that. Overwhelmingly positive response to it. And I was just, I mean, I'm floored, you know, I'm very humbled by a lot of the support that I've gotten. It's been great, you know, from guys like you and Adam Sessler and all those guys. You know, we've all been friends now, you know, since the movie was done. And it's like, yeah, this is great having the support of really positive people around me. You know, it wasn't usually the case when I was coming up. So it's nice to have that now.
It's a really fantastic industry. I'm very proud to be a part of it.
Yes.
I'm super excited to know you. If you guys haven't seen the film, where can people check it out?
They can go to pixelpoetrymovie.com. They can get it from devolverdigital.vhx.tv and gog.com currently. And we just came out with the special edition this weekend, or on GOG on the 30th, it's coming out. Yeah, so check that out.
So there you go. You can go to gog.com to get the special edition.
Yes.
Make sure you check out Pixel Poetry and follow Richard on Twitter at
RichardCook1985.
There you go. You guys keep watching Redbeard TV.